Dude's getting freaking ganked. Dude, look at your sword just melting, bro. Hello everyone and welcome back to episode number 2 here of Cosmic Sky. We're of course on the server today. Reset happened just yesterday, or possibly the day before if you're watching this as a video actually. And we have made a little bit of progress on the island, guys. As you guys can see, we no longer have wheat in this middle part. And actually, whilst I'm talking, I'm actually going to start farming this up. So we no longer have wheat in this middle part, guys. We've pretty much changed it all to potatoes, literally just through grinding. I figured that this isn't really the kind of stuff which you guys are going to be wanting to see on camera. So whole of my island and the members that are on it just grind out for potatoes and literally went ham. And this is what we've got. So yeah, obviously this is not the most efficient way of farming potatoes, as a lot of you guys know, but that's fine. We're not really here for IS top. Like, I don't think that's ever going to happen. Who knows? It might do by the end of the season. Who knows where we'll be at? I can't really say that because I know a few creators that started last season definitely didn't expect to get anywhere, but as I say, ended up on the IS top. Now, today we're going to be doing a bunch of different things, hopefully including adventures, finally getting spawners on our island, and we're also, hopefully, going to be redeeming something which you guys may have spotted in my inventory, which is indeed the rank 2. This is player rank 2, okay, so this is obviously the second rank, that makes sense, and it was purchased for us by Dylan over here. So Dylan actually went ahead and bought himself rank 5, which is, by the way, absolutely insane. But at the same time, he also got a free loot box, which he opened, and unfortunately he didn't get anything too amazing from it. But he also bought the rank 2, because he bought the gift card package, and essentially with that you get $100 worth of items. So he thought he would buy himself rank 5, and then he would go ahead and actually buy me rank 2, which is super cool of him. Like, that's so much appreciated. That's absolutely incredible. I never expect anything like that, but it is so, so cool of him. So shout outs to Dylan right there. He's helping us out, not even just on the island, but giving us freaking ranks as well. So massive, massive shout out to him. I'm going to just replant this whole farm right there. And as you guys will see in this double chest, we have been grinding up these potatoes off camera and it's all been going well. So if you have a look in here, I've also just started smelting them. We've got a bunch on us right now. As you can see in my balance, guys, you know, there's so much for me to update you right now. With our balance, most of it got paid to me by someone just now in my live stream. Obviously, I am still live streaming this episode, guys. So if there's anything weird about this episode, I'm live streaming it. So head over to my Twitch, twitch.tv/Generzon. I live stream, hopefully, pretty much at 9 p.m. nearly every day. So head over if you want to see some Cosmic Sky live streams, because that is what we do. We live stream the episode and we record it at the same time. So that's what we're doing. So head over to my Twitch to see that. But essentially, someone came in and they were just like, yo, I've just paid you, like, I can't remember exactly how much it was. It was like 43k, I think, or something like that. It was 40 something k, and that's kind of where half my balance came from. But the rest of it came from me selling wheat and potatoes overnight. So you know, it's kind of a little bit of both has happened, but I have now turned slash pay off, so don't worry, I will not be going crazy with letting people pay me, because I don't know, I feel like, you know, if I'm going to keep my progression on my island fairly, like, solo, then I feel like I should keep my money fairly solo as well. So yeah, that's kind of the deal with that. That's why that's going to be toggled for now. But pretty much that's about it that's changed. Obviously, we've tiered up our farm here just a few times so that we've got a little bit more efficient farm going. But what I want to do with these farms, guys, I really want to move them to, like, down below my island and have, like, the whole island pretty much as a farm and make it as efficient as possible, just so that when, you know, when we're getting short on money, we can literally jump down, farm them, and then we'll be up with money again. So yeah, it will be that's kind of the idea, and that's what I want to get done, if not in today's episode, then definitely in the next coming episodes here. Now obviously, we have got so many more cobblestone nodes. I don't even know how many this is, but we've got a lot more now. And obviously, this is staying the same. I don't really want to have any more log resource nodes, because I feel like that's probably about the right amount that we want. So yes, oh, do you know what would be funny? You know how I say, okay, if you're in my streams, then you know that whenever I start recording, I say hi to YouTube. Okay, everyone that's watching this on YouTube, I want you to say hi to Twitch in the comment section. I'm pretty sure that's how that works, right? You guys can say hi to Twitch in the comment section. I'm pretty sure we can do that. All right, what do we got? Let's craft this into bread real quick and get it all sold, because we can make some extra money right here. May as well. What else we got? How many potatoes? All right, we might as well wait for those few to just go ahead and smelt. But whilst we're doing that, guys, I think it is time that we claim our player rank 2, because this is going to be a huge, huge help to us. So without further ado, here we go. 3. I'm assuming I just right click this. 3, 2, 1, boom. There we go, rank 2 is now unlocked. We have ourselves 2 player skill tokens as well. So we can redeem these in slash skills. I'm going to have a look at what we can actually do with this. So we can do island skill, we can do PvE skill, or we can do Now, what should we do? 25% XP from mob spawn and mobs. Resource node insta respawn chance. 10% outgoing PvE damage, minus 50% food loss. Okay, I think I'm just going to go for island skill. Island skill is probably the best one, simply for the fact that if we ever get two more skill gems, or whatever they were, we can literally go up to slash fly in all non-PvP zones, which would just be super, super cool. So definitely in the Twitch chat, let me know and we'll make a decision real quick about this. I'm thinking island skill though. What do you guys think? Island skills so that you can get fly with it, since that's what you're focusing on the most. Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. So we're literally just going to go boom and then boom and that's us done, I think. Yes, there we go. So we now have a chance to insta respawn nodes, which is super, super useful. And yeah, that's going to be cool. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and sell everything that we have available to sell right now, which means we've got these bread. Boom. That's going to sell. That's another 2k onto the balance. And we've got about two stacks of jacket potatoes. Let's sell those. And that is going to add another $14,000 onto the balance, bringing it up to $76,000 in the balance. We're doing pretty good right now. I'd say that, you know, our money's doing pretty well. So, guys, I'm actually at Gundle's Island right now, which is actually someone that I have heard a lot from. Like, I know that they play with Miss Gladiator a lot, and obviously I know Miss Gladiator, and Dylan is stealing all of my freaking coal right now, but essentially he has got a island that has a bunch of coal nodes available for us to mine, which is super useful because it means that we're going to be able to start smelting all of our potatoes up, and that's obviously what we want to do, simply for the fact that, you know, we're going to make so much more money per potato. I think, let's actually just double check in the shop, but I'm pretty sure there's quite a hefty difference between cooked and uncooked. So sell price of cooked is 100 each. I'm pretty sure that, I don't think you can, you even wait, you can, you sell, yeah, you can sell it. They're 50 each, so it's literally double the price. So we definitely want to be smelting. I've got 8 coal right now. We're gonna go back to our island and just get this all smelting up real quick. So let's chuck those in there. That should do a nice amount, and we'll also chuck another lot in there. And let's go grab ourselves some potatoes to smelt. What we're going to do real quick is we're actually going to up our IS level. I'm only going to do it once because I don't really have the funds to do it again. So we're going to go to level 3. And what this is going to help us with is us claiming our rank kit right now. So I'm going to go ahead and claim our rank kit. I'm actually going to clear out my inventory real quick first, just because I have a lot of stuff on me right now that I don't necessarily want. So if we do slash kits right here, it's going to show us the kit that we have available. It's this rank kit right here, and it is just, it's going to be based on my island level, and my island level right now is 3. So hopefully that means we're going to get something decent. Right click to preview the kit. Let's have a look. It's going to contain a money note that will be between those values. It's going to contain 1 to 2 rabbit spawners, which is very, very useful because those are going to be our first spawners right there. And it's going to contain 1 to 2 abandoned ruins adventure loot, which could potentially be very, very good, but we'll see. Let's go ahead and claim it right here. Boom, there's our rank kit. And without further ado, let's right click to unlock the contents. 3, 2, 1, and boom, there we go. So we got 1 rabbit spawner, which is a bit of a rip. We got a money note for 430k. We did indeed get a chain helmet with blast protection 1, aqua affinity, and curse of binding. Yikes, that's going to be a mad yikes. We did just get a stone gem as well. Gem finder 1. Increase the chance to discover a mystery enchant gem when manually mining resource nodes. I'm going to have to place into gem forge to apply. I'm going to have to look at what that is because I genuinely don't really know what that is. But we do have our first rabbit spawner right here. I know that Dylan's got a bunch of rabbit spawners also saved up. So this right here should be the first spawner of a collection of spawners. Now I'm hoping that this actually works right here. Come on, come on, show me the rabbits. There we go. Dylan's got so many freaking rabbit spawners, it's crazy. Actually crazy. There we go, there's our first little rabbits right there. Perfect. So we're gonna be able to grind up XP and of course probably challenges with that bad boy. So that's pretty cool. We still need to fish up 25 trout, which leads me into the next thing for today. Now I was gonna buy a fishing rod, but I feel like at this point there isn't much point since we already have one in this chest. So we have got a lot of fishing to do. Now this is a level 9 fishing rod, and it can catch up to trout. So yeah, we've got to be careful. Obviously the durability on them is fairly low, so I've got to be careful that they don't break, because yeah, that's going to be a rip if they break. Dylan, what's up? What are you doing, fam? Are you about to drop me a better rod? Is that what's going on? Okay, you take that one. I'll take this one. This one's a level 25. Okay, I don't know what the difference is in levels, so I really do want to have a look. A fishing rod made of spider silk. So this one can catch up to salmon on the proper island level. I'm assuming we don't have the proper island level for that. I'm assuming we only have it for what we need it for. Now, what happens when I... Okay, it got away. So I'm assuming this just keeps happening until... Yeah, Okay, how long does it actually take to catch a fish on here then? Like an actual fish. So I'm assuming what we're going to do here is AFK, do a little bit of fishing because I've got a lot of trout to catch. We did just indeed catch our first trout, which is not bad. I'll take it. And we'll see how long it takes us to get up to the 25 trout that we need. I think it was 25 from memory. So yeah, we're going to have to... Oh, we're going to have to grind this up. It's going to take us a while, but we've already got two, so it might not be too bad. But this is exactly what live streams are for, so, you know, it's going to be all good. The guys in my stream can enjoy my fishing for the next hour as it takes me to get up this amount of trout. So I will see you guys in the video once I've got myself 25 trout. So we are one fish currently off of, well, one trout off of completing our challenge. So we're just waiting to, oh my goodness, we're getting fished out. Oh no, please don't tell me this whole area is fished out. Okay, we're good. This area right here is fine. Let's see if we can manage to get our last trout. And if we do, then we will complete that challenge. I don't remember what the reward was for the challenge though. So we'll have to have a look at what that is right there. And boom, there it is. Challenge complete, 25 trout. Let's see what the reward was. A lava bucket. Are you kidding me? I literally just grinded that amount of trout for a lava bucket. You're having a laugh. Harvest 64 cobble fragments from a cobblestone generator. So I'm assuming that literally means just stand over here and mine for a while. Now, I could just sit in this lava and mine like this because this is what I've done. These are cobblestone resource fragments, right? Yeah. I'm assuming this is what it means. I'll just check this slash CH again just to make sure. Yeah, that's what it means. So we can literally just sit here. By the way, this is a very, very nice stone generator. I don't think I had this in episode number one. So this is kind of a little bit of an update for you guys as well. This is what I've now got. It's chilling. It's chilling pretty well. I'm not going to lie. It's definitely a lot more efficient than just having the one. So I definitely recommend doing this. Very, very simple to make. I'll let you guys see that. And you can stand in the lava. So if you're scared about everything getting burnt in the lava, literally just stand in the lava and do what I'm doing. Because I was grinding on it yesterday and it literally just kept going in the lava. So I was just like, you know what? I'm going to stand in the lava and then this is what happens. So yeah, it's pretty efficient. But we're about to complete this challenge already. Well, not quite. We've got another half a stack to go yet. But, you know, we're pretty much nearly there. I don't get how the trout challenge comes before this one. Yet the trout one is so much harder. Like, I don't know. I feel like the challenge should be in order of like... how like their difficulty, if that makes sense. I don't know, maybe that's just me, but that's how I feel. Either way, we're about to get this challenge done. And what was the, I didn't even look at what the rewards were for this one either. Like, I'm so bad. Let's actually have a look quickly what we're actually grinding towards right now. We are grinding towards a cobblestone resource node. Is that it? And then we have to harvest 50 of those cobblestone nodes, but that's fine because we got a bunch of them going over there, and this will actually make us another one as well. So I guess in the long run it's actually just helping us out, so it's all good. Wait, did it work? Yeah, it did. Okay, there we go. Perfect. So now we just got to harvest these, and we'll actually get an extra rabbit spawner once we do so as well. We actually got given a cobblestone node for that, so that's two just to add right there. Now we got to harvest 50 of them. I'm going to put myself out right there because the fire's a little bit annoying. Here we go. Let's go ahead and harvest all of these right now and see how many this actually is, because I don't know. Why is everyone GGing? What happened? Someone won the jackpot with literally freaking 1.6%, and they just won $5 million. That's crazy. I think when I was on last night, it was even crazier. Someone won it with like 0.5%, but that's actually mental. So that's not bad at all. We'll take that. So let's wait for all of these to spawn back in. Let's see what my challenge is looking like. So yeah, it was 39. Perfect. So, and then we'll get ourselves a rabbit spawner, and then we've got a challenge to kill 100 rabbits. Yo, what the heck? How are you hitting them through it? Actual freaking hacker, man. Actual hacker. Dylan's a hacker. Confirmed. You've seen it here first. And yeah, there we go. All right. What have we got? Have we still got things smelting over here? Or can I sell these? Yeah, I can sell these. I think Dylan probably stole half of them. I'm not going to lie. Slash sell hand. Let's get rid of those. Perfect. All right. How long have these got until we can mine these again? 4 seconds. Perfect. By the time we've literally mined them all, they're nearly ready to spawn back in. We are going to need another pickaxe though. I've just noticed that our pickaxe is about to die on us, which is not what we want. Now we will be going, like I said, into the adventure mode today, which I'm kind of excited about. Never done it before. Have really no idea what I'm doing in it. So that's kind of what makes it mostly exciting, is that literally anything could happen at this point because I don't know. I haven't got a clue. But I guess we shall see what happens. We've nearly got a stack of cobblestone actually to use, which is kind of cool. But this should get our challenge done. This will get us a extra rabbit spawner. Here we go. And in 3, 2, and 1, we should have the challenge done about probably in the next 2. There we go. Boom. Challenge complete. Slash C. Wait, no, it's not slash C. It's slash challenge. And let's get our rabbit spawner from that. And now we can make a leather armor set if we kill 100 rabbits. So that's going to be a fairly easy. Oh, there we go. There's our potatoes. I think Dylan put them in a chest for us. He didn't steal them. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. where can we add this to make sure that it actually still makes a difference? Let's just put them right there for now. I'll put them right there for now. It's all good. There we go. There's that challenge done right there. Just sell it, sell hand. Okay, awesome. Let's go ahead and claim that then. That will give us a leather armor set, which we don't actually need. Place a permission block is the next one. I think it's time. I think it's time we do an adventure today. We need to actually go ahead and craft our first set of armor right here. So I've actually got it all ready to go right here. So this is going to craft everything that we need besides a sword. So let's just quickly do that. Oh, wait, we only need one of those. There we go. Perfect. So this is going to craft us our first set of chainmail armor, guys. So that's what I'm excited to do today. Boom, and let's go chest plate right here. Dylan has slash fix, so that's going to be useful. Leggings, helmet, and boots. There we go, perfect. There is a full set right there. And then, of course, we're going to need ourselves a sword, which should be just like that. Perfect. This is going to be our first set of armor to go out with. I don't know if we're meant to be putting any enchants on them, to be honest. I feel like probably not for right now, because I don't know what to expect, so I don't want to like waste enchants by going in. So we'll see. Now, this is indeed our hashtag first armor as well. So we've done our hashtag first sword and hashtag first armor today. So we shall see what happens. For now, we are fine. Perfect. So we're going to grab a few people into our voice chat real quick and see what we can get done. I think I'm just going to go for it. So
yeah, I'm going to hop in adventure.
Slash adventures. Let's go. Number one. Boom. All right, where are we meeting up? What's the deal here?
I guess we'll just come towards your coordinates, Jen, since okay, you're perfect. The one that we're going to be meet up to.
And how does this actually work? Like, what am I looking for here? Is there?
So you're gonna find structures. Different mobs are gonna show up. Essentially, they're just bandits in the adventure realm. They protect. Yeah, they protect chests, which have loot in them. The harder the chests are the more guys that there are around a said chest, chances are the loot's probably better quality.
Yeah, let's head over. Look at you in your freaking enchanted gear. What are you, dude, I
got a full prot 3 set, jeez, sharp 2 man. Sword.
All right, so we're basically all hiding behind you is what the deal is, right?
Pretty much, I guess so.
Wow, that man's running fast, bro.
Yeah, he probably got a speed pot too, because I'm not catching up to him. I'm catching up to you guys, but...
Yeah, I'm not catching up to him. I was. What the heck? He must. How did he drink it?
He's gonna get destroyed here.
A pot's. Oh my goodness! There's a guy over there. There's a bandit. Is that what we have to kill?
Yeah, bandits. Oh, there's a. Yeah, so he's gonna get killed by this thing.
No, that's a weak bandit, though.
Yeah, this is not a crazy strong one by any means. I keep it away from. There's more behind you guys. Be careful.
I got him. Oh wait, no, I didn't get him. Oh, nearly.
Hey, I got the
he died. I see a guy over this side. I don't know whether it's one of our teammates. Who's that? Oh, he's got no armor. He's got no armor. He's chill. So where are the chests? Just randomly in the buildings? Oh, I see. I got one right here. There's nothing in it.
So, they might not have things. They could be looted. If you find chests and you can't open them, if you right-click the chest and try to open it and it doesn't open, it'll usually show where the mobs are that you have to kill, what bandits.
Oh, I understand. Okay, cool. So what, bandits are assigned to a specific chest then?
Yeah, okay. Pretty much. Good.
All right, let's head up. Should we head up this hill, I guess? Since there's... Oh my goodness, there's bandits up there. There's crazy
there's
bandits.
There's lots of them.
I don't think
there's savage bandits. There's... Oh my goodness. Not gonna lie, we just completely played that...
You left me.
Played that dude. Wait, you cannot open this while there's dangerous creatures nearby. Where's it at?
Yeah, so it'll show where the creature is. Make sure you keep your...
I see.
Too, by the way. Otherwise, you will die a lot quicker.
Yeah, for sure.
He's just gonna chill.
Oh, he's getting freaking spawn trapped. Let's go.
Yeah.
Let me know when he's dead. I'm gonna open this chest real quick. What's our cause? 207 minus 350. Is it dead? Oh, no, there's another creature nearby.
And now he is.
Oh, it's just boots.
Oh, we got. I'll take him. And they got a socket on them, though.
Oh, that is good. We might as well try to clear out this house here with all these guys.
Yeah, let's do it. Oh, he's got an axe. I don't like him. Who's shooting bows? Out.
It'll be one of the other bandits. If you need to back out, Jen, just back up.
Yeah, I got it. Ah, that guy has poison. That's not very nice of him.
Yeah, most of them...
destroyed. Let's go. Oh, look at that guy right there. Bloodthirsty bandit.
Oh, that's two dudes. Three dudes. Okay, hello. Four.
Woohoo! Dude's getting freaking ganked.
That's just...
Dude, look at your sword just melting them, bro. I can't even.
Oh, I know.
Actually just melting them. Alright, where's this loot at? Show your boy the loot.
Might want to watch out, we're getting swarmed. He had a lot of potatoes on him. I'll take that, happily. Hello, that's fire aspect.
Ouch.
I died.
Oh, that hurts. What the heck is killing me?
Is there a person?
Yeah, I think there's a person. I died.
Yeah, where's he at?
Oh, that dude literally dropped me real quick, bro. Real freaking quick. Who killed me?
Oh, hello. Okay. Yeah, that's real fun. Alright. Pots. We need pots. Lots of pots. And I'm dead.
Oh my goodness, bro.
Well, then.
Whoever just came in, our first adventure was not a success.
Well,
yikes. That guy had had a little bit of power to
it. It's that fire aspect.
Yeah, man. Okay, guys, so that is pretty much going to be it for this episode. So as you guys can see, we're working on this farm right now down below my island. It's literally just down at the bottom. What we're doing is we're going to fill this whole thing up, and this is going to be pretty much just our big farm, and that's what we want to be doing. So that's the idea, and yeah, this is going to take a lot of potatoes and such to fill up, but hopefully eventually it will become worth it, and that's just how we're going to be doing things. Now, obviously adventures didn't go how I would like them to have today, but that's okay because that gives us a little bit more of an idea of how much gear we're actually going to need. So that's what I'm going to begin working on for the next episode. Obviously, I'm going to be farming pretty much between now and next episode. That's pretty much what I'm mostly going to be doing now, just because that's stuff which you guys don't need to see on camera. But if you do want to see it, then I'm still going to be live streaming on my Twitch. It is just twitch.tv/Generzon, so if you guys do want to come and join. And yeah, so that is pretty much where I'm going to end it for this episode. For you guys on YouTube, hopefully you have enjoyed. If you have enjoyed it, you know what to do right now. Smash that like button. Of course, if you're not already subscribed, that would be much appreciated. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in today, and I'll see you in the next episode of Skyblock here on Cosmic Sky.